If you've seen any of my videos on this channel, you know I am all about making visual story and narratives. Check out the last video, Footprints in Eternity, markdkberry.com, and I shared all the info about making that, and 18 workflows are free to download up there. Now, it's time to prepare for the next project, and I have been researching all the new stuff since finishing Footprints back in June, and we have some cracking new methods and speed-ups now, so I am really excited to be getting to the end of this research phase and getting going on the next project, which will be The Highwayman. So let's get stuck in. I'm going to do a series of videos, but this first one was me testing a great model called Phantom. And I need to address one of the big problems, consistency. I don't want to train Loris, but I probably have to, but Phantom might deal with it, and that is what I want to show you today, what I figured out. I also share my workflow with you. To start with, what you are looking at on the screen is the Phantom workflow, so let's have a quick look at what is going into it. Actually, before I start on that, a couple of things. The music underlying this video is mine, and if you are into that, go check out my Bandcamp site at markdkberry.bandcamp.com. I also get like 0.00001¢ royalty if you play it right through, so there is that. And yes, this is that famous bloke for London doing the talking and not me, but never mind that. I am testing out VibeVoice and it seem okay. Is whatevs. So let's get back to the point of this video and the Phantom workflow you can see on the screen. Up the top left, I have a bunch of LoRAs. Those are from that model you have all heard of, Fusion X. But not a lot of people realize Fusion X is just 6 LoRAs baked in with a wont 2.1 model. Those are some of those LoRAs. The important ones are Light X2V and Fast 1. Between them, they speed up the workflow, so I need to use 6 steps, and we'll get to that in a minute. Next, have a look at the block swap and torch settings. I recommend installing Sage Attention. I have Vode version 1 installed of that, but it helps. Also, PyTorch 2.7 and CUDA 1.8 are installed on my machine. I have Windows 10 running with 32GB of system RAM and the entry-level GPU card, the 3060 RTX from NVIDIA with 12GB of VRAM. Did he say that right? And probably not. I'll put the important dates in the text in case my man talks jive turkey gibber like a honkin' tondule, ain't it? Flubby dubby wobby nibby wibby anyway. Sorry about that, moving swiftly on. You may have already noticed this is a wrapper workflow, and that means it was coded by the great man himself, Kijai. Yes, we all know who he is, and if we don't, we should. The alternative to a wrapper workflow is a native workflow. I switch between and test both, so there is no hard and fast rule about this. I use what works. Today we happen to be working with the wrapper. The Phantom embedded to allow us to put up to, I think it is 4 different images into the workflow and the Phantom model. Which I realize I didn't mention, but the Phantom WAN 14BQ4KM GUF model. Yay, that one. That is a T2V model, which means text to video. The equivalent image to video I will talk about in another video is the Magref model, and they do similar things very well. They maintain consistency of the images you feed them. In fact, both these models deserve a lot better recognition in the AI scene than they currently get, but I think that is slowly changing. Phantom is phenomenal. So is Magref. Before we look back at the embeds and why we are looking at the model loader nodes here, you notice I have the VACE module bypassed currently. There is a reason for that. VACE is like the Swev army knife of AI models. It can do pretty much anything. What a few of the guys on Bandico Discord have been mucking a beat with is a merge model of VACE with Phantom. I get into this later too because it's pretty special, but ignore that for now. It was just some me trying to get VACE and Phantom working together, but to be honest, on a 3060 GPU, it's a struggle. The GGUF models also need a mention, since they recently started working with wrapper workflows, and sometimes they were better in native, like wrapper. I often use FP8 models rather than GGUF models, but that's another story too, for another day. The GGUFs are good. I'm happy with Q4, mostly because I have to watch my download limit, and I had gone over it this month testing all the models.
Let's get back to the Phantom embeds. First, let me apologize for this voice because it is crapping out a bit.
It's the first of using VibeVoice in Comfyui and I'm not finding it that great yet. I figure it out for the next video, so bear with me in this one. So what I have here is 3 characters for my stage play, The Highwayman, and I want to get us sitting together at a campfire in a certain order. Phantom will that, it's pretty good. but it has some caveats. Firstly, we need to do a few things with each embed. Here's the hero of the story, Silvio, and first I need to remove the background and rotate it with white, then resize the image, which I use Lanxos. Then I use a Kijai node to pad some white around it. That is the color 255, 255, 255. Actually, it looks like it isn't doing any padding here, as everything is zero, but that's fine, it worked. Then there is the WAN video encode, and finally it goes into the WAN video phantom embed node. That goes via image embeds into the sampler. I haven't figured out what those settings do in the embed, so I left them alone. The result of the background removal you can see in the image screen shot. Another thing I quickly mentioned before we get to the sampler is the clip loader. You see, I am using a GGUF model there too, and I talk about that in a memory management video very soon, as that is one of the tricks to squeeze as much as I can out of the 3060 GPU and low RAM system that I am running. More on that in a future video. Probably do it next, actually. So moving on to the K sampler, or in this case, the WAN video sampler. Using the LightVex 2 LoRa and the FastWAN LoRa means I had set steps to 6 and config to 1. Now, if you talk to the Bandoco dudes, they seem to think that Phantom needs higher config, but so far, I haven't found that to be the case, and they have better GPU cards than me, so probably could take advantage of higher config settings. If you set that higher, you would double the T it takes to finish the workflow. This works for me, so I am sticking with the 6-step and 1 config combination. Shift is kind of odd. I spent a lot of time looking into it and still don't know what works best. I tend to go middle ground and put it to 5, but it varies. When going for consistency, try to find seeds that work with models. Take a note of them and reuse them later. The reason is that the model has been trained on a data set and each seed likely amplifies a different data set. I don't pretend to understand how it works or that I know what I am talking about, but it seemed to me that trying to force the models to look a certain way is fighting with the models in a way. So if a seed works, stick to it. I note down seeds that work as I go. You will also find a seed that works for your man looking at the camera, might not work so well when he is looking away. Hopefully Phantom addresses most of this, but it is something to think about. Save your seed information. Where was I? Oh yes. Scheduler. Look, I just don't know. Euler, UniPC, LCM, Bong Math, blah, blah, blah. Just try that. I think it's a rabbit hole and so tend to mostly ignore it. I think all this can get too complicated, and it does. So what is left to mention? Nothing. So let's look at some results from this workflow and talk about my findings. No, let's talk about the prompt first. That is important. Again, I like to start simple, but the gurus will tell you, and they are probably right, that you need to get really complex if you want what you want. I believe prompting is a black art, and in the future, everything in our lives will be driven by a prompt. For now, let's just keep it simple, but that doesn't mean slacking on it. Here is my prompt. It's not very PC, is it? Well, that's the kind of guy I am. Get over it.
Three men sit around a campfire in the woods. On the left is the man in blue with a mustache. In the middle is the fat man, and sat on the right is the man with the brown tricorn hat. You think that will work?
It's fairly descriptive. Let's see. First, here is the guys remembering the prompt as we look at the...
Three men sit around a campfire in the woods. On the left is the man in blue with a mustache. In the middle is the fat man. And sat on the right is the man with the brown tricorn hat.
Why is VibeVoice giving me music behind that? I don't know. Anyway, here is the best I got for this workflow using that prompt. I played it twice there. The video is 82 by 480 by 121 frames and at 24 frames per second, making it 5 seconds long. On my 3060, it took about 10 minutes. That did the good result. There were plenty of failures, and I talk about why next. It's pretty good. I have some issue with the guy on the right in the tricorn hat, but I can use Vase later to fix up faces. But I think this is a winning shot for the most part, and I can work with it. I talk about what I do next in another video, which will be about getting multiple camera angles and setting up first frame, last frame workflows. After that, I will post a video about dialogue and how I address different shots with that. So let's talk about the quirks of Phantom quickly and what you get when you don't do it right. First thing I discovered was it doesn't like doing less than 121 frames.
At 81 frames, you get clothing failure.
At 49 frames, you get midgets. And heen is what you get while testing for best seeds. Seeds do make a difference, as you can see. Okay, I think that is all for this video. Thanks for stopping by, and sub SI Cyber and all that jazz for further adventures in AI filmmaking. Next time, I'll address memory tricks for Comfy and talk about ways to get the most out of a 1-2 GB VRAM machine. I also try to sort this terrible voiceover out. Thanks for sticking it out. Ciao for now.